We are the Blak Sovereign Movement representatives here today. Sovereignty has never been ceded. Our sovereignty does not coexist with the sovereignty of the Crown. We are the original and only sovereigns of these lands. We are saying no to the referendum and no to the voice. The voice is in violation of our ancient protocols. It is not a self-determined body. There has been no free, prior and informed consent. The voice advises on how the government can govern First Nations peoples. But we have never agreed to be governed by the colonial Australian government, and we do not acquiesce or surrender now. The voice is just a vehicle for unwanted constitutional recognition. We do not want to be part of the colonial constitution and the attempt to rule over us and our lands. This is not an invitation. We are the first peoples of these lands. These are our lands and our lives. The Blak Sovereign Movement.
Nyambo, sovereignty. Wolaju. Kulaka existed there, lawa. Sovereignty grand or one of men, lawa. Nanan Bernalo, Chunganyanity, Wikinu, sovereignty, Yapa, Yamboarding about Australia, warding about. Voice is you, when I lower, when I lower. Carbon, when I do car, when I do work your man, nay, work your man, nay, young or low, Iran. First Nation worrying about it, but never worrying about it. Wulakanalo, nyerpa, kini jalan, manuangkan. No, jangan nukuja, lawa. Ngalabay apa, ngulajo, we won't, kulonalo, surround with that. No, kapunan nyanu yinyi, lawa. Number two, violent. One of our own, lower. Correll, put a correll, one guy made, one of you lower. Lower. My manual. Number one, number one, one of your animal. Malipa, yapa. Manu yapago ngalipa Blak Sovereignty Movement. Thank you.
I'm going to hand the voice to the Blak Sovereign Movement.
All right. I just have an offering. My name is Michael Anderson, and been at this for a long time. But I think it's time we started buying something back. The land was taken from us for nothing. But we're not that greedy. So what we're doing is we're offering a blanket to King Charles and a set of beads to be taken back to England. So Anthony Albanese, do what you want with it, but that's a gift for the King. We're taking our land back. And our people, out there. I don't know where he gets his figure of 80% of Aboriginal people supporting the sovereignty movement, but I the Voice, and so I don't think that that Albanese has any grounds to stand on. And we must make the point that Linda Burney is a Minister for Aboriginal Affairs, but she's also a representative of the King of England, and she's not our minister. She's representing the King. Thank you.
Yeah, I just want to, Marion Hedlund McKay, Noongar, WA. I just want to say that the Voice, you know, is not supported. It's, these polls are not reflective of the voices on the ground. And the reasons you don't know that is because our voices are constantly silenced. And this is what happens right across the country. We've had enough. We have the world's highest incarceration rates. We have the world's highest suicide rates. We have the world's highest forced child removal rates. The Voice to Parliament is not going to change any of this. We need adequate resources given to Aboriginal people on the ground to manage our own affairs, because nothing is going to change unless we change it ourselves. This government was created to oppress and deny and silence our people to our ancestral rights that we were given from birth, that we have never, ever ceded. And we do not cede our ancestral rights to any of these lands. You all need to understand and recognise that we are the first people of this country. This country is stolen. We stand on land that is illegally occupied at the expense, detriment and death and torture of our people every day. That is why the deaths in custody recommendations from the Royal Commission have not been implemented. That is why hanging points are still in our prisons and our detention centres. This is why our kids are still being tortured in places like Banks Hill Detention Centre in WA and Dondale in the Northern Territory. This is because your society allows people to abuse and inflict pain, suffering and torture on our people, because our voices are silenced and ignored every day by a government that stands there and says they're trying to protect us and make things better. And I say to you, this government does nothing for our people. We don't get nothing for free. We have to protest for change in this country, and we protest against the Voice. I do not want anyone speaking for me and my family. Tribal boundary law. No one has the right to speak for us, because we got our own voices to speak. We don't need a voice constructed by a colonial regime that fights every day to silence it and kill it out.
This land was taken from us at the point of a gun. Our people were murdered. 400 of my mob were murdered. The babies' mouths were stuffed with dirt to smother them. People's bodies, when they were just wounded, were thrown onto fires to try and get rid of any evidence. My father was denied an education. My grandfather served the First World War and wasn't allowed to join the RSL Club or get soldier resettlement. I'm the first generation of our family that went to school, because our parents told us that we had to learn the white man's way in order to fight them. I miscarried a baby in jail, fighting for our rights. There's pain every day in our hearts, and it doesn't go away. It does not go away. And now we have black people in Parliament who are agents of the Crown trying to sell this beads and blanket deal to us. This government will never be able to repay me for what happened to my family and to every black family in this country. The 1967 referendum, more deaths in custody than ever. More babies being taken away, dragged from the arms of their mothers. Generations, my beloved grandmother taken away. And the pain never goes away. And this voice is not going to make any difference to us. So whoever came up with it, and those black people who stand in front of you, they're not connected to us. And we just got to do something better. It's time for a real talk, you know. It's time for a proper agreement. It's time for reparations. I'm living on somebody else's country. We're refugees in our own country. It's got to stop. There's got to be a better deal. No more beads and blankets.
My name's Fred Hooper. I'm the chairperson of the Murawari People's Council. The Murawari Nation declared our continued independence and statehood, our sovereignty from the Crown of Great Britain in 2013, 10 years ago. No government have come to us and spoke or talked to us about our self-determination, about our rights under international law. The voice and the wording of the voice, it's meaningless. Because you know why? It's a voice of no choice. This voice of no choice that they're putting to the Australian people didn't come from the First Nations of this country. They didn't consult all of the First Nations in regards to this voice. Yes, I was at Uluru. And there were insults going on at Uluru. And my sister here, she bore the brunt of it. That's why we walked out. We were bullied. We were bullied into asking, or people were bullied into agreeing to something that they didn't even write. Let the Prime Minister and, you know, Minister Burney show some faith. Let them set up a Sovereign Truth and Reconciliation Commission right now. Put it towards Parliament right now instead of a worthless voice that means nothing. That means nothing to us as well. So this voice don't represent the Murawari Nation. We are a sovereign nation. We became, or we've always was, a sovereign nation. We just made it known in 2013. So if the Prime Minister wants to talk to the Murawari Nation and all the other nations around the country, not just one, and you must remember that there were several nations when Captain Cook first came into Sydney. We all had our own laws and customs as well. They're not taking any of that into consideration when they bring us under the colonial common law. Now, we must remember also, there are court cases down through history. Versus Bonjon, I think it was 1941. Versus Ballard, 1929. You had a history of court cases, and the latest being Love and Thomas versus the Commonwealth, 2021, I think it was, where they said they are not citizens of Australia. They are citizens of their own group, which means they are citizens of the Goongri Nation and the Gamaroi Nation or the Kamilaroi Nation. They are not citizens of the Commonwealth of Australia as well. So there's the beads and blankets that they gave us as an offering. Take them back, King Charles. We don't want them anymore. You know, put them somewhere in Buckingham Palace. Or better yet, come out here. Come onto our country and apologise on behalf of the institution that you are the head of, including the Commonwealth Parliament of Australia, for all of the things that were done under the instructions that came out of Buckingham Palace. And remember, the instructions also said treat with the natives. But what do? They said, oh, look, you know, there's nobody here, so how can we treaty with anybody or treat with anybody, right? So the voice. I don't know how it's going to help the Murray Nation. I don't know how it's going to help people in jail. I don't know how it's going to help the struggling mothers out there. I don't know how it's going to help our people, because if they were genuine about helping First Nations people in this country, they would have done it long before now. Nothing's working. Thank you.
Thank you.
Since Cook sailed his boats here, 230 years ago, there's been no consideration given to the rights of our people, the lives of our people, and the honour of our system. We've never surrendered. Our hero, Windradyne of the Wiradjuri, fought at Bathurst, fought to a standstill, and we have taken the position of Windradyne. We do not surrender. Our children and our grandchildren belong here. Everybody else got a ticket from someone from somewhere. That ticket was invalid. Take it back, get your money back and sail back.
Sorry if I'm shouting. I'm glad that today I'm here. I'm here representing my community. Representing because people out in the communities really don't know what is the voice? What is it? Nia voice is it? What is it? Because Nia Kuja, no gonna you the millabin. No gonna anybody nyambula government in the millabin. Millabin jalagalu, but kulaba longalba imbangaraka. Meaning, our voice, the voice that we guessing, wanting, what is it? If I hand you a piece of paper in my language, in Wadbury, would you ever dare to sign it? No. No, you wouldn't. Because you wouldn't know what I'm saying, what I'm asking. So yababadu yiri yiri jarelipa nyambojo voice lawa ngaye kango yuyulgenyu kango nyego walyaku kango yuyulgenyu. What I'm saying there is voice is not the answer. The voice is saying the land want to give it back. It's not telling the truth. Thank you.
That was Uncle Ned from Yundamu. My name is Adrian Burugaba. I come from Wangan Jagalingu country. As we have said, and we always say, there's been no consent, there's been no contract, and there's been no free, prior, and informed consent. We must rely on first law protocols. First in time, best at law. This is what we've always said. There's got to be proper consultation right across the board with all nations, with all law people. You can't just deal with a hand-picked group of people and say they are a representative body before the United Nations and before the world. It's got to come down to first law protocols. And we just say no, because there's no voice here, only the voice that we're saying. Never been represented. Never spoke about the atrocities, the massacres, the land theft, the murders, the genocide, ethnic cleansing, the scientific racism that's based in this whole colonial system, that we were just monkeys and that you could go out and shoot us, give them licenses, partial us, to kill our people and take the land off us.
These are the questions. That's the voice we want to hear. What's the truth in all of this? For all Australians to go forward in this, you all need to know the truth. Because there's no free, prior, and informed consent. Not everybody, not all Aboriginal people in this country, in this nation, has been consulted on this matter.
Hello, my name is Nayaka Cove, and I'm Radri and Gomeroi. I'm here today to stand with my people to say no to the voice. Pretty much the government are trying to manufacture consent in this country to say that they have a right to negotiate on their terms about our sovereignty in this country. We, as a people, have been silenced in this conversation, and a lot of the representatives do not represent the interest of the people, they represent the government's interest, the Crown Corporation. So if you go out into our communities and you ask a lot of our people what's going on, they're confused about this conversation because none of them have discussed or been spoken to or given, they've been giving misinformation that the government are trying to put out there amongst the media, amongst their representatives. At the end of the day, we are who we are. We cannot negotiate on sovereignty because our law prevents us from doing that. We come from ancient people. It's time for Australia to wake up and realise what yous are doing. Yous are signing away and putting our people in graves. We're burying our people before their time. Time to stop. Wake up.
Hi, my name is Leah House, an Aboriginal Wiradjuri woman. My community does not accept our political role as sovereign people of this nation as an advisory body. Our sovereignty is not inferior to Australian sovereignty or what Australia perceives their sovereignty to be. And we aren't interested in my community is not interested in participating in a process that's only going to further seek to uphold the illegal occupation of our lands. I've been marching since I was born. I was taken to the High Court with my grandmother. We were born into this movement, I and Jen Munro, all of us, back in 72, the 10th Embassy. So these are families that have lived this their entire lives that were born into this. And I've never once marched on the streets for constitutional recognition. I've never heard my elders call for an advisory body.
And last,
I'm Samuel Wirrip Watson. I'm Wanjirubar and Birragaba, and I'm a member of the Black People's Union. The voice is not land rights. The voice is not environmental justice. The voice is not judicial reform or change. The voice is not a step in the right direction. At best, the voice is a distraction from those demands. At worst, it is absolute sabotage. What we've been saying, in the Black People's Union is that we deserve better than just a voice. And I think that is the best way to put it. We deserve better than an advisory body that can do materially nothing for our people. We deserve better.
Well, there you have it. Black Sovereign Movement. It's not a Lidia Thorpe show. There are credible senior law people behind me who are part of guiding the Black Sovereign Movement. So that's my party room, or part of the party room.